Thanks for staying with us at STL Live. I'm Sarah Thompson, and my guests are Visionary Award honorees Lana Pepper and Shiraz Gorman. Thank you both for being here.
Thank you.
I thought I should start things off saying congratulations. And we can kind of, Lana, we'll start with you. Your category for being recognized is Major Contributor to the Arts. Mm-hmm. And we should say these are contributions in the arts, not necessarily philanthropy.
Right. It's time and sweat as well as money.
And one organization that you worked with for a long time was Shakespeare Festival St. Louis. Is that correct?
Yes. That was started back in 1998. The first production wasn't until 2001. But it was a lot of hard work those years getting it to that point where we could make a big splash in Forest Park for the first year.
And what is it that you love the arts, you love performing arts, you just wanted to make this happen for St. Louis?
Yes, and I had just finished graduate school in directing, and the whole 2 years we were using Shakespeare. And so I had just finished that master's degree. And Crosby Kemper came to me and asked if I would work on a Shakespeare festival in the park. And it was just like a dream come true.
Mm-hmm. And now when you go to Forest Park and you see a chunk of the summer where thousands of people come out, how does that make
you
feel?
And when children come up, small children, and they love it. And that was one of our goals with the educational program, was that the children would see the mini version of the play, and then they would drag their parents to the festival. And it happens all the time. It's just our dream come true.
That's wonderful. And Shiraz, I mean, for me to take, we don't have enough time, I'll just flat out say. I mean, your bio, visual storyteller, poet, author, award-winning advertising copywriter, two-time TEDx Gateway Arch speaker. Your poetry has been on Ebony Online, Huffington Post, everywhere. So I'll start right off saying you are clearly an outstanding working artist, which is your category.
Thank you.
People can read all about you online. Let's maybe talk about something that you're working on now, kind of shifting gears in terms of your area of artistry. What are you working on now?
Well, one of the things that I'm most proud of that recently happened, that was February 28th, where I hosted Not So Late Night for Left Bank Books, where I had the honor of interviewing poet Eve Ewing, and Hanifa Durakib. And for me, that kind of marked the space of, oh, I'm a poet, but I also can host and moderate like this late night talk show that's dedicated to the literary arts. So, you know, shout out to Left Bank Books for that opportunity. Yes. Because it was great.
Yes.
To get the community to come out on a rainy day in St. Louis on a Wednesday night to a packed house. That was huge, you know.
Yeah.
So,
and you wear many hats. I mean, as a poet, an artist, an arts administrator, mm-hmm. I think a lot of people are familiar with your work. People are familiar with Atta Ferguson, mm-hmm. some profiles that came out on you from some of your words around that. You're now moving into the area of film. Is that correct?
Yes. And it's almost like a full circle moment from when I started off in the arts. I was actually a commercial photographer. I started off as a photographer and a poet parallelly, and went away to ad school and just decided to kind of narrow myself. I do not recommend that. never narrow yourself. So for me, working in advertising and doing script writing for commercials and all of that, to take my work now and to start turning some of my poems into short films, is a beautiful and exciting thing for me. And it's making me step back into the game as far as directing and producing pieces, because myself and another artist by the name of Jacob Berkowitz, who I'm in the Screwed Arts Collective with, we did a short documentary film on our collective member, Chris Birch, who is an artist from St. Louis, but based out of the Bay Area now. So we did that a couple of years ago. So now, having that come around for me, it feels pretty good.
That's really cool. That's really cool. And that's great. I mean, it fits so perfectly with your category. It just keeps coming and keeps coming. And before we end, I do want to mention, Lana, you're actually doing now, you've shifted gears from the Shakespeare Festival to the St. Louis Literary Awards. Is that correct?
Yes. Uh-huh. I've been working on that for about 4 years now. And if you've never looked at the list of winners of the St. Louis Literary Award, it is the most amazing list. Last year it was Margaret Atwood, And this year, coming up in October, Stephen Sondheim will be coming to St. Louis to accept his award. And he's so excited to be put on that list of world famous authors, okay. The best.
Yeah, well, congratulations to the both of you, and thank you for coming here to talk a bit today.
Thank you.
We've got the information there for you on the screen. You can see more of Lana and Shiraz at the St. Louis Visionary Awards when they're accepting their actual awards, and then stick around afterwards where they have a reception with drinks and hors d'oeuvres. It's coming up on Monday, April 23rd at 6 p.m. at the Sun Theater in Grand Center. For more information, go to visawards.org. There's more STL Live right after this. Please stay with us.